Hey everyone, Dave here, and welcome to Sniper Elite Winter Warrior Overview. When it got announced, it was quite a surprise that it's coming, though not necessarily, and that's a spoiler alert. The main character is a grandpa that tells the stories through his experiences when he was hot, young, and movable. So there is an infinite possibility to create as many games as the devs want because of just that setting. We've done the whole playthrough. I have a lot of stuff to talk about, so let's get started. So Sniper Elite Winter Warrior is a sequel of World War II action shooter game, where in this iteration we'll be once again meeting up with the Nazis and uncovering their new wonder weapons that has to be destroyed for the overall success of the Italian resistance. Couple notes from the first title are as follows. It was overall a good experience, but very much diminished by the death choices and gunplay mechanics for the most part. The flying holster, uncomfortable switching between the main weapon and the secondary ones, awkward magnet hold where you couldn't even aim with your weapon like a normal person, you were pretty much fighting with the game. The standalone port itself was pretty cutely done, like you would barely notice the difference between the PC VR and just the Quest versions. The main gripe for me, however, was the star system and unlocking ability to go further in the campaign and the storyline. It was absolutely not seamless, because in later stages you'd have to repeat the first ones to accomplish some kind of challenges that were contradicting the main objective, and you'd have to repeat it couple times to even succeed, which would result in me struggling to go towards the ending and repeating stuff that I absolutely did not want to for much longer time than it took to do the proper missions. Now, having said that, seeing this trailer, to be honest, I don't see that much difference between those games. I feel like people already forgot how good looking was the first one, and nothing that I see comes off as a surprise, nor anything relatively new bringing to the whole project. So my wish would be to just pretty much eviscerate the problems that the prequel had and all the annoyingness within it, cause if not, then it might be a repeat in the making, and I don't know if I'll do the playthrough based on just the memories alone. Let's again snipe some people.
A strong wind and the sound of the barn doors banging woke me. I had not seen weather like this for a long time. Looking out of the window, memories came flooding back to me. Over 40 years ago, memories I'd kept secret for such a long time. After my initial part of the war, I had later been recruited into a covert special unit. My skills had caught the attention of the Allies, and I was more than willing to put them to use. The cold cut through my hands like glass. Squeezing the trigger would be difficult, but I needed to test my aim.
We're still in the same place as we were before. Granted, everything is much sharper now. I played the first one on Quest 2, right? So this is like the transition of the pancake lenses. Yes, I know, thank you. I mean, the graphics were always good here, so I won't complain ever about it. I've seen through the settings and stuff like that, there is more to customize, definitely. So maybe this is gonna be a different experience.
Hello, my old friend.
There is no snapback. It's like I'm going into the past, playing the same game but with just winter assets. Okay.
It did not take long for the emotions to come back to me. It was like I'd never put the gun down.
Game. Wait, what about the focus? Ah, yeah. And then we had like a fall off.
The focus was key for the perfect shot.
Depending on the distance. I still love the sound though. Almost perfect zone. Oh wow. Focus is definitely needed in longer distances, which... How did that kill him?
Every bullet I fired reminded me of the struggle that had come before and how it was about to start once more.
Oh yes. It's still the same mechanics.
The Nazis were on their back foot, falling back as the Allies pushed up through Italy. The enemy dug in at the Gothic line, an impenetrable line of mountainous defenses. Not a concern for me. I would be dropped in behind with one purpose: hunting and destroying Nazi secret weapons. Weapons they believed could change the tide of the war. This I would not let happen. As I looked deeper into the blizzard, I could hear the sound of crashing waves, the boom of a gun. I cannot hide this past anymore. I waited in the shadows for the optimal time to strike. Watching from a distance, I knew patrols would be lighter. Focused on my goal, I needed to make my way towards the gun. Staying undetected would greatly improve my chance of success.
This is the same map from the first game. Like, literally. It's one of the last ones, but... why? I'm not going to stealth mode here. It's full on action, baby. Ah, oh. Cut the tutorial. Where is he? Okay, I won't play around.
Find the heck!
The gun began to fire. I could use this to my advantage.
Where's he running? Kill cam's juicy as always. My god. There's a lot of tooltips going on. Which is fine for someone that never played this game. Damn, their detection is very much heightened.
Carefully timed shots would keep my location hidden.
I don't know about the hidden part. I mean, I'm essentially worrying that it's gonna be a repeat with the mission requirements to progress. So when the alarm will go off, I'll just check quickly in the menu. But I really hope not. Had a great time in the tutorial, but not here. Okay, well, I spoke too soon with the detection. I need to find out what's happening with the other weapons? Doesn't seem too bad.
My path to the turret was blocked. I'd have to find a way to open the door if I wanted to progress any further. I knew I mustn't hesitate so close to my objective, but what I found would set my course for the rest of the war.
Ah, it was a safe station. Did we have like a map or something? No jumping as well. Wait, where do I go? Another gun.
While searching for a key, I came across intelligence that proved invaluable. Wilhelm Leonhardt, the highly influential general known for developing advanced weaponry. He had set up base at a villa somewhere in the west. Taking him out could be critical to winning this war.
Seid vorsichtig!
I need at least one weapon. It does seem very similar from what I've played before. Although, I think it feels enhanced. I was kinda surprised it was very cheap. We're again destroying the gun.
The explosion rang across the beach. There was no hiding my presence now, but I had to make it out alive. The information detailing the whereabouts of General Leonhardt would prove pivotal in stopping the deployment of Nazi wonder weapons.
Oh shit! Jesus! That was a clean hit. Okay. Just in case. The arm already went off and I tried to go to the home base, but it resetted essentially the progress, so I can't figure it out if we actually need to have certain numbers of stars to progress. Either way, the mechanics and overall the gameplay seems much smoother and it's very fluid. Is it a completely different game? Absolutely not. It's just the different assets, but the same first map and enemies, weapons, pretty much everything. So that could be very well a DLC to the prequel rather than a full-on standalone game. I think it's cheaper, if not the same price though, so I guess that's fair, and it's the same Sniper Elite vibe I was getting before, though I think it plays better. Are we gonna continue this? Yeah, sure, why not? I mean, it's a good old sniper, so I don't really see anything that's holding me back. We'll eventually see.